Penguin would have just beaten me to death right there in front of everyone. He wanted to. And if Batman hadn't been there, I would be... Of course, the doctors aren't thrilled about me leaving. My therapist is worried the drug might have caused some issues to resurface. Make them unmanageable.
Our stock is tanking. The board is losing confidence. Wayne Enterprises needs a new face. Oswald Cobblepot.
You're the only ally I have in this building. It's important. I need you to be my eyes and ears.
All right, I can do that.
Keep Oswald out of R&D, and let me know if anything comes up.
You're a good man, Bruce.
Please, Selina, I have to tell you how I...
Bruce?
You should come stay with me.
I'll think about it.
Dropped your pen?
It's not...
You have to face the truth sometime.
Retribution, Bruce.
Okay, I'm up. I'm up.
For Christ's sake, put some clothes on. Doctor's making the rounds soon.
Doctor? What doctor? Is that my blood? God, I hope it's mine. Looks like someone was angry. Lovely. This can't be real.
Better be decent. You settled? Good. Anything you need? Water, piss, rat poison? I've been asked for rope before. Not really allowed to give it out. Of course, I could make an exception for you.
You can tell me why I'm in Arkham Asylum for a start.
What, rich boy doesn't remember? Oswald Cobblepot? You beat him to a bloody pulp. Nearly killed him. Landed you here. Any of this ringing a bell? Might as well get comfortable. This is your home now. Time to meet your neighbors. As you were.
You look just like him. Your father ever tell you about me? How he sent me here? Left me to rot in this goddamn hellhole? Somebody's gotta pay for that. I hope to God there is a hell. I want your daddy to see what I do to you.
You really don't want to do this.
You don't know a damn thing about me, Wayne.
What's going on in here?
It's like I told you, Doctor. These creeps were attacking the new guy.
Well, who did that? Was it you?
Of course not. It was mostly over by the time I got in. The new guy's tougher than he looks. Right, buddy?
Bruce, is that really what happened?
Go on, tell her.
Yeah. Yeah, that's what happened.
We have a very strict no-fighting policy here in Arkham. If you can't obey that rule, you're going to find yourself in hot water fast.
The orderly that was here before took money from these men and let them into my room. He gave them a taser.
I knew that you coming to Arkham could cause some excitement, but I didn't expect it to happen so fast. I'll do my best to keep you safe, but I need you to be careful.
Us nice guys gotta stick together. Am I right?
Come to me if anything happens.
Thank you. I appreciate the effort.
I'm glad you're so understanding after what just happened. Good thing help wasn't far away.
Hey, I'm just looking out for the new guy.
I'm Dr. Joan Leland, by the way, head of psychiatry. I'll be overseeing your case personally. We'll get you transferred to a new room, Bruce. One that doesn't have your blood all over it. For now, follow me.
I'm sorry, I don't think I ever got your name.
Me?
He's never given his name out to anybody.
What?
You just call him John Doe.
Bingo.
John is one of our most improved patients. He's been with us for quite some time. I'm sure he'd be willing to show you around. Right, John?
Oh, yeah. I'll show him the whole nine yards.
I think it would be best if you stayed by his side.
There's not enough black tiles, you hear me? There's too many white tiles!
You know, Doc, our last session was so enlightening.
That's good to hear. Your next evaluation is in a few weeks. I'm glad you're starting to understand yourself better.
Oh, every day, Doctor. Every day.
I can't taste anything! I want to taste!
You got gotta be more careful, Bruce. Some of these guys bite. You remember the first time you let me into the rec room, Dr. Leland?
How could I forget?
You had to teach me how to play checkers.
Yes.
No! No! You need to let me go! I have to warn the president! You're trying to kill me!
You don't know the president.
They don't like it when you try to use the phone.
That's because phones are for staff use only. No exceptions.
Stop that guy from trying. Such persistence.
Wrong number, dumbass!
Stop! I'll come by to check on you two later.
Come on. Don't worry about us, Dr. Leland. Just take another fight. I'm gonna take good care of you. Where is Welcome to Arkham Asylum! Believe it or not, some of these people are crazy. But everyone's friendly, mostly. I'd watch yourself around those two. Not a big fan of strangers. And just a little bit, you know, prone to outbursts of violence.
What did they do?
This is Arkham, Bruce! Use that sick little imagination of yours. Murder, mayhem, carnage, the usual. Let's see. On the couch, that's St. Louis. Ooh, his favorite show's on. Never misses it. All right, friendo. Commercial break. Get up! Where is the remote? One of the orderlies must have taken it. Never fear, though. I'll go ask Leland. She likes me. Ooh! I almost forgot. Here.
What is this? The right key for this.
You got a bad case of the mind knives. I can tell. I can tell. Just shove off, all right? No mind knives for me. I already got my shots.
That's the way the cookie crumbles.
Hello?
Hello?
Go away! Arnold's busy. I swear, if you bother him, I will gut you. I solved the cookie riddle, not you.
Sorry. It's his voice! It's driving me nuts!
Oh, but you're already nuts.
Sorry, I can't talk right now. I gotta keep my eye on this guy. Hey there, buddy boy. You missed me? I missed you.
However, the threat remains. The children of Arkham are still out there, and I will not rest until these streets are safe and firmly under my control.
Never anything good on, is there?
Bruce Wayne, you've got quite a reputation around here. Taking your enemies out to stay on top. I like your style.
So what's the deal with that?
Well, this one was a homeless guy trapped in a hopeless life. This was a woman who just couldn't stop cheating on her husband. This guy wanted to kill himself, but didn't have the courage. All lost souls that I freed from their earthly woes.
Okay, yeah, that's enough. Thanks.
Wait, that's the move you're going to make, huh? Yeah. Why?
Why?
No reason. No.
Batman really did a number on this guy. Just let him be.
Lewis!
Hmm? What? No, that wasn't me. I'm sane Lewis. And that was... that was crazy Lewis, you see?
What's that?
Oh, no, no, no. That's not polite at all.
Hey, I was wondering about...
It's not lunch yet.
Well, actually,
and
I wasn't...
It's not time for meds, either. Beat it.
Would you mind controlling me? Doctor says that's against the rules. For the last time, Taylor, I'm not mind controlling you.
Your key, it didn't work.
Of course not.
That's not how you get out of here. You tried it though, didn't you? That's hilarious.
My enforcement squad has already seen great success. They stopped a massive attack being organized out of a local SkyTrain depot.
Politicians usually bore me to tears, but this one has become a lot more interesting lately.
In my Gotham, no one's above the law, including Bruce Wayne. After his vicious attack on Oswald Cobblepot, I had Mr. Wayne committed to Arkham Asylum, where I hope he'll receive the treatment he so desperately needs.
Double-crossing, two-faced. I thought you and the mayor were friends. I mean, you were supporting his campaign. I saw all sorts of photos of the two of you together.
Harvey was my friend. I can't believe he's the one who put me here.
Sounds like you need better friends. Slim pickings around here, though. I've looked.
In which Mayor Dent announced the creation of a special enforcement squad under his direct command to combat an imminent threat from the children of Arkham.
Rest assured, we will find these terrorists, their stockpile of drugs, and their leader, this Lady Arkham, before they can strike again.
Now, this is good television! Mayor on a rampage versus freaky drug terrorist.
I'm gonna find your drugs.
I'm going to expose your corruption.
Oh my God!
Won't someone save my baby?
This isn't a joke. Their war is going to destroy Gotham.
That's what makes it so funny. All those people caught in the middle.
Tragically, there's still no sign of Gotham Gazette reporter Vicki Vale after her mysterious disappearance earlier this week.
Very tricky, Vicki. I think we both know she's quite the, lady. Right, Bruce?
Wait. You know that Vicki is...
Tell me what you know.
You wanna find Vicki and her drugs, huh? Get your revenge just like you got your revenge on Cobblepot? publicly and dramatically. Something entertaining for these newscasters to talk about. Ooh, I'd love to see that.
Well, that all depends on you. If your information is good, we'll see.
I knew I liked you. I've been watching you for a while now, Bruce, and I can tell there's something darker in you. When you attacked Oswald, I could tell you enjoyed it. If those cops hadn't dragged you off of him, that Cobblepot punk would be dead.
That wasn't me. I was just pumped full of her drugs.
Those just amplify what you're already feeling, what's already inside. Don't be ashamed. It's in your blood. I see a lot of your father in you. She probably does too. It's obvious that's why Vicky hates you. Your dad helped bump off her parents.
Why would my father have the Vales killed?
I never said he killed the Vales. She was born in Arkham. Victoria Arkham.
What?
You didn't know that? The Arkhams did not approve of what your dad and his partners were doing. They were gonna blow the whistle on the whole thing, so your dad, well, pop, pop. Her parents murdered, leaving her with an unquenchable thirst for vengeance. Surely you can relate. Tragedy can drive people to do some pretty dark stuff.
Don't try to make this about me.
Of course it's about you, Bruce. This is all about you. You and Vicky are both dark souls, and now you're heading on a collision course towards each other. That's gonna be fantastic! You see, I know what you really are. And that's why I really want to tell you where Vicky's moved her drugs, but you're not gonna do anything while you're stuck in here. So, I vote we get you out. How hard can it be? You're Bruce Wayne. The Waynes always get what they want. All it would take is a phone call.
Well, sure, but there's no phone.
Assume I can take care of that. But it's gonna come at a price. When I get out of here, you're gonna owe me a favor, okay? Just one. Yeah, don't know what it is yet. But what's one favor between friends?
Sure, one favor, that seems fair.
Excellent. We'll have loads of fun. You'll see. All right, tell you what, I'm gonna make a distraction to get the guards away from that gate. The rest is up to you. You make that phone call, and I promise I'll tell you how to find those missing drugs.
Hey, Zaz! Hello, Zaz.
What the hell do you want?
Settle a bet. What happens if you make a tally mark before you kill someone?
What are you talking about? Ah! No!
No, I don't match him.
Oh god, I don't match!
You can fix that right now!
Skin feels like it's itching. Burning! Need to get rid of it!
Ah, stop! Someone get me a sedative! Run, Brucey! Run!
Damn it! Call security!
Hello?
Alfred.
It's you, sir. It's so good to hear your voice.
I've been trying to contact you, but they wouldn't let me through. They told me you'd lost your mind.
Contact my lawyers. You'll need to post bail, but that shouldn't be a problem.
You have got to get me out of here.
I'll see what I can do.
I have to go.
Oh, Bruce, I have not had this much fun in ages.
Let me tell you how to find Vicky's stash of missing drugs. Ask the Vales.
Quickly, come on.
Good luck on the outside, Bruce.
I just know you're gonna put on quite a show.
Pretty grisly scene in there. Multiple stabbings. One of the orderlies had a finger bitten off.
Doctor, I swear to you, I was not involved in any of this.
We're going to look into it further before I feel comfortable making a decision one way or the other. One moment. Seems you have a visitor.
Alfred.
Ah, Bruce. Thank heavens you're all right. You see, everything is in order. He is to be released into my care.
You may have the money to make this go away, but this is going to hurt you in the long run. What happened with those men in your room? The riot with Zaz? You clearly need help, Bruce. He needs extensive evaluation, treatment.
Dr. Leland, you know it isn't safe for me here. Look at what happened today. That won't be the last time.
That may be true, but I would never let that hinder someone from getting the help they need.
I'm afraid it's out of your hands now, Doctor. You have the paperwork.
Let's go, Alfred.
I will see you on the outside, Bruce.
I can't wait!
What was that about? Well, I just can't believe that Lady Arkham was actually Vicky Vale this entire time.
And all the while, she was working with Cobblepot to try and bring me down.
It's a good thing the family lawyers were able to get you out so quickly.
No kidding. Batman's got some work to do.
Even during Batman's brief hiatus, Gotham has become that much more dangerous. And the public opinion on Bruce Wayne... Well, it certainly hasn't gotten any better.
Yeah, well, that's why it's Batman's turn now.
True, I suppose public opinion doesn't affect him much. Though, if the people protesting to have you thrown back in Arkham get their way, that could put a damper on things.
Hello, Harvey.
You should have stayed in the asylum where I put you.
What do you want, Harvey?
The streets of Gotham are a dangerous place for someone like you right now. Well, you'll figure that out. Eventually. But by then, it'll be too late.
Just leave me the hell alone, Harvey. Trust me, it'll be easier for you in the long run.
I was doing you a favor, Bruce. If you want to get ugly, well, that can be arranged. Maybe you haven't heard, but the children of Arkham have gone underground. Obviously plotting some sort of attack, and people are scared, panicking. I needed to show them that my resolve hasn't weakened, that Gotham is still strong. So I gave them an enemy. You and your family's filthy corruption. The last thing I need is you traipsing around Gotham,
Would you listen to yourself? You sound insane.
No. I'm just a man who's done letting assholes like you run the world and take whatever they want. Can't let you keep running around scot-free, Bruce. It's the will of the people.
You can spare me your will of the people crap, Harvey. I know this is personal.
You knew I was interested in Selina. What you did was a low blow, Bruce. A real man wouldn't have done that. A friend wouldn't have done that.
That isn't how I wanted things to go down either, Harvey. And I'm really sorry they did, but that is no excuse for this ridiculous crusade against me.
I don't need an excuse. You're a criminal, and I'm coming for you. Bruce? Bruce!
We're done talking. What's going on here?
Well, well, well. Bruce Wayne. You really must have done something to piss the mayor off so much, hmm? Maybe I'll get a bonus for this. Open the trunk. We're searching the car. Now, if we find anything tying you to the Children of Arkham, including drugs, weapons, or any other suspicious materials, you will be taken into custody.
I know my goddamn rights, and you better have a warrant to back that up.
Don't need one. Mayor Dent gave his enforcers full search and seizure rights.
Come on, what's the damn holdup?
Get back to your car!
Of course. Should've known. Go back to Arkham, you damn maniac!
The hell?
Careful, or you'll be the next cobblepot.
Showing your face in public like this? Not real smart.
I am tired, I am hungry, I haven't showered in 3 days! I want to go home, and if you don't get the hell out of my way, I swear to God, I will have this car run you over and then back up again just to make sure it did the job!
Bruce.
Shut up, Alfred, I can handle this!
Someone else heard that, right? This psycho just threatened me!
Yeah, I filmed the whole thing!
They should lock you up!
Oh, God, I... Alfred, I'm sorry. I don't...
You'll be fine. We just need to get out of this mess.
Nowhere to run, dirtbag!
Next one won't be a warning shot!
All right, now the way I see it, there are two ways we can do this, Bruce Wayne. Either I let these people at you and see how you handle mob justice, or you could make a little donation to me and my boys to help us stay well-funded, hmm? And well-armed? What do you say?
They've got us blocked in. I can't back up. This is turning ugly, sir. What would you like to do?
Hey, the mayor's gonna hear about this, and it ain't gonna make him happy.
Hey, he's the problem, not us!
Back off, people!
Bruce!
Hey, your father committed innocent people to Arkham and made sure they stay there for the rest.
Ram the barricade!
This isn't the Batmobile.
Just do it, Alfred! Hey!
What do you mean you're leaving?
Bruce, Harvey's clearly lost it. All over the news yelling about how you need to be brought to justice, throwing whoever he wants in jail. Not really interested in seeing what he has planned for me. I was supposed to be here laying low. Does this look like laying low to you?
You don't need to worry about Harvey. I'll protect you from him.
Don't write checks you can't cash. Don't you get it, Bruce? Harvey catching you in my apartment drove him completely around the bend.
So you're saying you think his breakdown is our fault?
Yeah? Don't get me wrong, Bruce. The night was a lot of fun, but... not worth dying for. He's dangerous. You understand, don't you?
Okay, don't you think you're being just a little overdramatic? Harvey wouldn't kill you.
No? Look what he's done to you. And you're the type of person who shows up in headlines. He could have me killed and no one would ever know.
So where are you gonna go?
I got some other business I need to take care of.
What other business?
Look at yourself, Bruce. You're in no shape to take on Harvey. Or the children of Arkham, for that matter. Of course. That's my car. See you around. Good luck with all of this.
Computer.
You're exhausted. And the influence of Lady Arkham's drug may still be affecting you. You've seen the way it's still affecting Harvey. He's a paranoid wreck.
Harvey is turning Gotham into a police state. Oswald has stolen my company, and we need to find Vicky and the children of Arkham before they strike again. I can't just ignore it.
You're in no condition to work. You absolutely must get some rest.
Then help me. Feels like the whole damn cave is coming down around me.
Of course I'll help. Let's start by addressing the problem at hand.
You're right. Let's just focus on getting my head clear first. Bring up everything we know about Vicky Vale's drug.
Yes, of course.
If I can isolate the presence of the drug, I should be able to synthesize an antidote. Start a DNA scan. Compare it to my DNA on file in the back computer.
I'll make the preparations.
This is the refined sample of the drug taken from Officer Montoya after she killed Falcone. Here's my DNA before the incident. It seems that the drug attaches itself to specific proteins in the genome structure. If we can modify the drug's molecular structure, we should be able to create a counteragent.
Once you've figured this out, we'll have a working antidote. We can cure others affected by the drug.
No. I wish that were possible. This cure is based on my DNA. It'll only work for me. To cure other people, we'd have to sample and decode the genome structure for each and every person to make them an antidote. That should do it. This needs to be injected directly into the vein to work.
I don't imagine it'll be much fun. Hopefully that does the trick.
It'll work, Alfred. I feel better already.
So, what are we going to do now?
First things first, I need to know what Vicky, Lady Arkham, has been up to while I've been away. Search for all children of Arkham recent activity. The press is reporting that Vicky Vale is missing.
Yes, and obviously the police have yet to find a body. That woman! Trying to get the scoop on you, pretending to care. She betrayed you.
I never trusted her. It was always something off.
Your instincts are very rarely wrong, sir.
She was playing me the entire time, breaking me down. She wanted me in Arkham. She wanted me to feel what my father had done to all those people.
Bruce.
There were bigger plans than me, Alfred. Batman stopped her at the Skyrail station, and I can't believe that she isn't finding another way to use the drugs.
Well, if that's true, she may be more dangerous than ever.
I know. I met someone in Arkham who gave me a tip on how to find her.
A tip? Do you really think you can trust someone in Arkham Asylum? No offense intended toward your recent time there, of course.
He knew that Vicky Vale was Lady Arkham. No one else has that information.
I suppose that's not something we can ignore, trustworthy or not.
He told me that if I want to know what she's planning, then I should visit her parents' house.
If the Vales still live in Gotham, they should be easy enough to locate.
Got it.
Bruce?
Yeah? If you do find Miss Vale, please, be careful.
I'm inside the Vale House. Alfred, the Vales are dead. One body confirmed, but there is a lot of blood. Alert Gordon.
Will do.
I don't know how this is connected to the drugs yet. Whatever they knew about it, Vicky made sure they kept quiet. Syringe. Seems she hasn't given up her old tricks.
Is this the same drug?
Yes. But this is several times stronger than the dosage I received.
Maybe she's escalating.
This seems personal. Her eyes are gone. Stabbed out.
That's disturbing.
There's an injection wound on her neck. Same kind Montoya and I both received, but this one's much worse.
Recent family photo?
Vicky's not in it. It shows the Vales with another child in front of an industrial office. There's a logo on the building. Large amounts of blood spatter across the walls. It's not steady like arterial spray. Someone was swinging wildly. Wait. There's a slight indentation where something bloody struck the wall with force.
Something thrown.
Nothing I can see. It's clean. This wasn't used as a murder weapon.
Then why was it lying on the floor?
Alfred found Mr. Vale.
Alive?
No. He's gone. 10 hours at least, judging by the state of his soft tissues. Looks like a company logo. The belt buckle is covered in blood. Before he was hung with the belt, Mr. Vale was beaten with it. Found a lock of hair.
Anything unique about it?
It was cut at a downward angle, probably with some force based on how clean the slice is. Same device, same drug. This confirms that Lady Arkham is the murderer. The logos match. Mr. Vale owned an oil and heating company.
Looking it up now. Yes, he's got a sizable warehouse in the industrial district and a fleet of delivery trucks.
And now Vicky's got it. Appears Mrs. Vale attempted to fight back with this knife, but only managed to slice through the attacker's hair. The indentation matches the shape of the belt buckle. It must have impacted with the wall during the attack.
What exactly happened in that house?
I think I know. After we stopped her at the rail station, Vicky needed a place to hide her supply of drugs. Her father's trucks and warehouse offered the perfect cover. To do that, she needed them out of the way. With Vicky Vale fully assuming her new identity of Lady Arkham, seems like she didn't need the veils around to support her old one. Vicky showed up to attack her adopted parents, but only the mother was there at first. Miss Vale fought back and was able to slice off part of Vicky's hair. Vicky then subdued her with the same drug she used on me, but a much, much larger dose, nearly lethal. She then removed the mother's eyes, indicating a deeply personal motivation. This was obviously some sort of vendetta. Sometime during this, Mr. Vale entered. Vicky attacked him with his own belt, striking with the buckle until he was unconscious and bleeding out. Finally, she dragged him to the closet and hung him with the belt. The blood loss got him way before the hanging did.
Well, that's horrific! She never acted out in such a violent way before. Why would she-
Alfred, I think someone's still in the house, going to look for a heat signature. If anyone else is here, I'll find them. Clear. Nothing here. There's someone here, under the stairs, alive. It's okay. I'm not going to hurt you.
Sir, is everything all right?
It's a kid, Alfred. The boy from the photo.
Is he all right?
Aside from the shock and a few bruises, he seems okay. He might be able to tell me more about what happened.
Possibly. But if that's the road you go down, please do it with caution.
I need to know what happened.
No!
Tell me what you saw.
Go away!
I'm sorry I scared you. It's going to be okay.
Yeah?
I need you to tell me if you saw or heard anything. This is important.
I heard someone say something about drugs, fighting the police. I don't know who. I don't know who because I didn't see anything. I didn't see anything because they're hidden here. Please don't send me to punishment.
Calm down. See, that does help me. Thank you.
Get down!
Well, hello, Batman. What a pleasure to see you.
Penguin.
Let me guess. You're trying to figure out our next move. Figure out where the drugs are. Did I get it? Am I close? Pathetic. I've got these little bat traps all over the city. But I should have known a good double murder would be what brought you out in the open.
Nice work, kid.
They're dead.
I'm so sorry that I couldn't save your parents. You don't know how sorry. I promise, I won't stop until I catch the person that did this. You're the kid who saved Batman. And no matter what happens, no matter where you go, that will always be true. And I will always owe you one.
Batman!
Oh my God.
He was the only survivor.
Come on. Let's get you out of here.
He saved me.
Jesus. Was this the Children of Arkham? Again? Why would they attack a family like the Vales?
Because their daughter Vicky is Lady Arkham. She killed her own parents so she could use their company warehouse to stockpile the rest of her drugs.
Vicky? Vicky Vale, the reporter? And so, who was the boy then?
My guess is he's another foster child living with the Vales. He says he heard something about drugs and attacking the police. Can't confirm anything, but it sounds like the Children of Arkham might be plotting something with those drugs against your people.
Thanks for the heads up.
The warehouse is Vale Oil and Heating. You should secure it as soon as possible.
I'll get on it right away. What about you?
I've got something I need to look into.
Lieutenant, what's going on here?
Securing the crime scene, Commissioner.
Not anymore, you're not. I'm taking over this investigation. I can't risk you allowing Batman to contaminate our crime scene again.
So your bat stunner just didn't work?
That's right. I have a bad feeling it was no accident. Alfred, get Lucius on the line for me, please.
Of course.
Let's get a closer look at you. No damage on the microfiber. Adhesion regulation reads normal. Electricity conductor, everything looks functional. It should have worked. EMP functionality is all in the green. This doesn't make any sense. This is strange. This microchip is emitting a low bandwidth receiving signal, but it shouldn't be.
Like the ones you shut down in the GCPD.
Something like that. But Lucius had his eyes on the Wayne tech that the Children of Arkham breached. This is something different.
Bruce, I have Lucius on screen now.
Good evening, Bruce. How can I help?
I need you to see something. Sending you schematics.
God, someone's found a way to get past my security upgrades.
Not just someone. Oswald Cobblepot.
Bruce, I am so sorry. I should have caught this, but he snuck right under my nose. Mess. But that sleaze Cobblepot at the heart of it all.
Cut yourself some slack, Lucius. There's no way you could have known. I certainly don't blame you for it.
Well, I still feel a little guilty. Looks to me like he's introduced some sort of bug into your network.
That's how he's making my equipment malfunction?
For now. But if he keeps it up, he could completely take control of your tech.
My lord, that would be catastrophic.
Is there anything you can do?
I can try to work on your firewalls. But if I do anything too drastic, he'll know we're onto him.
I'm tired of being on the defensive. Why don't we attack him instead?
I'm not sure, but I can certainly see what I can do.
Thanks, Lucius. Excuse us, Lucius.
Of course. Reports of Children of Arkham activity are down. But these efforts do not come cheap. That's why I am formally seizing the Wayne estate, so the corrupt wealth of Gotham's elite can go to the better purpose of protecting Gotham's common man. Mr. Wayne has 24 hours to evacuate his property and turn it over to the city, or he will be removed.
You can't let that egomaniac throw us out on the street.
I have to talk to him.
Harvey is scared, paranoid, but he clearly views Batman in a favorable light. Then again, maybe talking to an old friend is what he needs. Harvey's behavior is unpredictable, random. Who knows how he will react either way?
Tonight, Batman saves Bruce Wayne.
Yes, about bloody time.
Don't screw this up, Harvey. I don't know if that was the right thing to do. Why did I do that? I just can't second-guess myself.
Bit of a strange place to hang out, isn't it, Dent?
Batman? Oh, you scared the hell out of me. Well, it's good to see you. I was just telling someone how much I'd love to get you on my payroll.
You've gone too far. Leave Wayne alone.
Wayne? What, is this about the whole seizing his assets thing? You're not gonna break my legs, are you? You're getting quite a reputation around town. You don't just make threats. You back them up.
Calm down, Dent. I just want to talk.
Sounds good to me. I'll admit, I'm surprised to see you helping Wayne. Seems kinda small potatoes for you. Maybe you haven't seen the news, but he hasn't been the most upright citizen lately. Why should I do anything to help him?
Your friend. He put his faith in you, supported your campaign.
He betrayed me!
He lied to my face while sneaking around behind my back. Wayne is just another curveball this stupid city threw my way. Hill and his goons, the Waynes, the children of Arkham. I'm finally starting to understand, to see just how sick Gotham really is. To save Gotham, I need to do some bad before it gets better.
Ready to go.
Do it. What did you do? Our Lady Arkham's drugs destroyed.
Man, we lost a bunch of our own guys. The apartment next door. Jesus Christ. Oh, man. That blast was way bigger than you said. We must have taken out a whole city block with it.
We stopped the children of Arkham. That's all that matters. That's what a leader does. I feel like I should thank you, seeing as you did give Gordon that tip.
I don't care what your end goal was. Even one innocent life is too high a cost.
Then you're thinking too small.
I doubt the police would see it that way.
There has been some conflict with the police, that's true. Like Gordon. Oh, he really wasn't happy when I went over his head to get the location of the drug stockpile. But I had him taken care of.
What did you say about Gordon?
Where is he? No, hang on, Batman, hang on. I had to make an example of him to get people to respect.
Gordon is on Gotham's side, Harvey. He's fighting for this city, too.
Batman, I'm sorry. It's like I told you. Crime Alley. They took him to Crime Alley! And here I thought we could work together. Let's take a ride, gentlemen.
Is this?
Mayor Dent says you're getting in the way of protecting the city.
Dent's got you brainwashed.
No! He's trying to help! The children of Arkham are out of control, and no one is doing enough!
Batman! What a mess. Thank you, Batman.
Save the thanks. And explain to me why I just watched half a city block go up in flames. Dent took out the warehouse with the drugs, the location that I gave to you.
Are you accusing me of something, Batman? Just say it. Come on! Let's hear it!
I only told you. Dent knows, so someone you talked to told him.
You know we're on the same team here. So stop leaning on me and let's figure out what happened.
Tell me what you know.
By the time I got back to the precinct, Dent already had the information. He strong-armed it out of Commissioner Grogan. I didn't even have time to scratch my ass before I got hauled out here.
Dent's position makes him dangerous. He's persuasive and he has power.
Dent thinks that what he's doing is best for Gotham. Executions and martial law.
I know.
There's no saving him this time, Batman. And there's no world in which he manages to set this right.
There's no hope for a rabid dog. We need to lock him up and throw away the key.
Oh, Jesus Christ. This is what it's come to. We have a lot of work to do. Everything is such a goddamn mess. But we gotta start somewhere.
The real threat on the streets is still the children of Arkham. they are what Dent is reacting to.
And standing in the way of dealing with them, too.
The precinct trusts you. The commissioner trusts you. Use that. Direct their focus.
Yeah. Gotta handle this first, though.
We will get through this, Jim.
I'm glad we're on the same side.
Lucius, what's the situation?
I figured out how he's causing the feedback loop. He's somehow connected a black box computer to your encrypted network. God, it's like a digital battering ram. If he keeps this up, he could smash through the Batcave firewalls at any minute.
He'd have access to the Bat computer. Hang on, Lucius. It's Alfred. I'm patching him in. Al, Lucius figured out how Penguin's cracking my security. He has a device that...
I'm afraid we have another problem to deal with. Mr. Dent is pulling up to the manor as we speak, and he's not alone.
Already?
Sir, are you all right?
Penguin's hacking assaults are getting worse. At this rate, he'll have my tech compromised by the end of the night. Only place he could be hacking me from is Wayne Enterprises.
Well, I don't envy your position. Even Batman can't be in two places at once.
I need to stop Penguin. You go to the Batcave and make sure Harvey doesn't find it.
I understand.
Time to go to work. Lucius, are you there?
I'm off site, but I've tapped into the security systems to give us an advantage. I can let you know where Oswald's guards are, and which routes are clear.
So long as you can confirm Penguin's black box when we're in the lab.
I can do that too. Avoid that hallway. More guards ahead. Go right. Wait. Drones ahead. Turn around. Head for the elevator. I'm opening the doors. Now!
Assume Oswald is in my office.
Naturally.
Damn it! Damn it! Damn it!
Does anyone have him? Useless! You're all bloody useless!
Hey! It's the Bat!
You're a dead man!
Well, if it ain't the biggest bleeding pleasure to see your sour mug again!
Gloat while you can, Cobblepot. I'm taking you down.
Yeah? I don't think so. In fact, I think it's you who's gonna get beat by me. I'm pretty good in a fight, you know. Been in a few scuffles here and there.
You seem pretty confident about that.
Yeah, well, I am. You know, I like your style, Batman. I really do.
But you're really starting to be a pain in the ass.
The children of Arkham are going to walk all over this city, and there isn't anyone who can stop us, not even you! But this company, under my expert stewardship, with the technology being developed, we could control nations.
You and your plans are over, Penguin. You're going down.
Wrong. This is just the start. You know, Wayne was thinking too small. He was only tinkering around. So focused on consumer technology. Lady Arkham, she has vision. That's why she made sure. Oh, I see. It helps you plan things out ahead of time. Neat trick, though. Pretty flashy for someone who only wears black.
How?
Not just for fashion. It's very functional. Face it, Batman. You're outmatched. Without your tech, you're just a man in a pointy-eared costume. You can't stop us.
Watch me.
Batman, show me what you got. My turn.
You're pathetic!
That little beaut is almost done hacking your precious network.
That's the device.
Few more minutes. All your secrets are mine.
I will stop you before that happens.
Oh, is this how it feels when you put on that suit? I like it. Haven't you learned yet? I've shut you down. I'm the one with the toys now, Batman. This is the start of a new legacy. And I'm afraid you don't have any place in it.
It's done, Cobblepot. Your revolution is over. It started with you, and it ends with Lady Arkham.
Oh, good luck. You'll never find her in time.
Where is she? What is she planning?
The message is the same as it's ever been. We will open your eyes. This city's hypocrisy will be exposed.
Tell me where to find her.
Piss off! Oh, I'm not telling you anything.
Tell me!
I won't. Do your worst.
What the?
Just cut me down, mate.
Sir, is this really necessary? I mean, what will people say?
Just tell him Wayne put up a fight.